this first technique comes after a Nagashe Uke slip to the outside. So she throws her right punch, aim punch in. Nice and committed. I want to move my head. So it slides over my shoulder. And that's just in case I mess up on the block. I don't want my head to be there. We're going to work that Nagashe Uke, head to the outside, and grab. Now, I'll show you from a couple different views. So the first is palm, backhand, slide, and grab. Now, the palm hand, the first one that blocked is going to stay here. The other hand that grabbed, I'm going to feed it over the top, and I'm going to grab my own wrist into what we call a figure four. So now she's got a bent shoulder with wrist up. Next view, she punches, block and move, grab, feed this in. Now, you can leave this here and you can feed it up. You can wait for them to pull their fist back and track them. It's up to you. It's really a matter of timing, but the important part is to control the wrist, to weave around, and to get control of your own wrist. So you get this nice and strong frame that works as one piece. We call it figure four. So first move and block, grab, figure four. Now, face this way, I'm gonna turn and face this way. You bring her wrist just over her shoulder, and as I turn, I will start to arch her backwards. Once they arch backwards, you can take her to the ground. Now, I don't want to take her to the ground due to some previous back injuries, so I'll let her do it with me so you can see what's going on. So I punch, she parries, goes the outside one first. So left hand. There, she got her grip, she got her figure four. Now, watch as she cranks my wrist back and it starts to affect my shoulder and then my spine. Once I'm bent backwards like this, I'm in a really bad spot, and all she has to do is put my wrist on my heels and I'm on the ground, which is where our side fall comes in. Notice it's got the extended leg, slapping hand, tucked chin, and all that, which is good for me. You definitely want to know how to fall while you practice this. So. But basically, you got two options. Once she's got me bent back in this position, if she is slow enough, I have the ability to fall to unwind the shoulder, which hit the ground's not good, but it's better than breaking my shoulder. If she decides to go full speed, it might just honestly rip my shoulder right out of the joint before I have a chance to fall. So make sure you practice slow. So in order to block this, palm, back hands, grab. Top. So she's got good position. Now she can keep turning. And once she's got this, I'm in a bad spot. From here, go straight down. So I'm going to take her down once, real slow, just to show you what the options are. And once you have this here, you can control your partner. Help bring them in nice and close. I like to actually pin them with my shins, and I still have control of this wrist right here. So you can lift up on this bent wrist, cause some pain there. Just move it back, start setting up arm bars down. So in order to practice the shoulder blocks without a partner, I'm gonna use a couple of random objects. Take a jacket, put it on a hanger. Now, I'm hanging up on this random statue thing that's in the house just so you can see what's going on, but I would recommend just hooking it up in your closet, just make sure there's some space. So we're going to be using these sleeves to represent the person. Now, obviously, the sleeve isn't going to have the same resistance that a opponent will, but it will allow you to practice it through. Now, just make sure you can see what's going on. We have two options. One involves when you slip inside and you end up with this left hand grip. The other, when you slip outside and you have this right hand grip. Now, depending on where you're at, that's going to dictate which shoulder lock you go for, right? So, if I am here on the outside gripping with the right, my left hand is going to loop around and grab my other wrist. Call this a figure four. Now, notice I'm facing to my right, I'm going to turn my hips. Face my left to crank that shoulder over the top. basically what we're doing is we're taking this arm and we're bending it back like so, and you want to crank it until that posture starts to get broken backwards. So we've got our sleeve, grab with the right, pull the top, so practice that motion, weaving through, grabbing your wrist, using this as one strong frame, and turning your body to take that wrist over the shoulder. Through. Make sure you turn your body to part support. So the other side, your image, over the top, hook your own wrist, turn. Over the top, hook, turn. Over the top, hook, turn.